So for this video, we're going to find angles 1 through 6. And we are told that the two horizontal lines, AB, is parallel with CD. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at this set of angles over here, all of these lines going on, 1, 5, 6. And what we see over here is we know that this top one is labeled 54 degrees. And when we have a little box here in the corner, that is understood to represent 90 degrees. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to take this line here that I have labeled, and I'm going to make a big angle here. This is called a straight angle. And what we know is that a straight angle is 180 degrees. So we have 1, 2, 3 angles inside here. All three angles have to add up to 180 degrees. So 54 degrees plus angle 6 plus this angle over here have to be 180 degrees. So if we know that that top right angle is 54, and we know that that bottom angle is 90, together that's 144 degrees. If we subtract that from 180, we're gonna get angle 6 here, which actually leaves us with 36 degrees. Right, so 54 plus 36 plus this 90 degrees here makes up that full 180. Now, another common concept when it comes to angles is that opposite angles are congruent. These are called vertical angles. So this angle over here, 54, is a vertical angle with angle 1, which means that they equal each other. So angle 1 must also be 54 degrees. And if angle 1 is 54 degrees, angle 1 and angle 5 make up a straight angle. So together, those should be 180 degrees. That tells us that angle 5, if we take 180 minus the 54 degrees here, we are left with 126 degrees for angle 5. One other thing that we know about parallel lines and the transversals that intersect them is that two angles on the inside here, right, angle 1 and angle 2, should also equal 180 degrees. So if we take 180 and we subtract the 54 degrees of angle 1, right, so 180 minus 54 gives us 126. All right, so that means that angle 2 also has to be 126 degrees. And if angle 2 is 126 degrees, angle 2 along with this angle over here have to be 180 degrees. So that means that this angle right over here has to be 54 degrees right here. Which means we now have this angle here, which is 54 degrees. This angle here, which is 90 degrees. A triangle has 180 degrees inside. So angle 3 has to be that leftover. If we take 180 degrees and subtract away the 90 from here, and subtract away the 54 from here, that'll give us what angle 3 is, which is actually 36 degrees. And angle 3 and angle 4 are a straight angle, so together those should equal 180 degrees. So if we take 180 minus the 36 degrees of angle 3, angle 4 is 144 degrees.